Albert, I don't know how you can just sit there when there's so much to be done, us having just moved and everything.
You can't expect him to do anything till he's had his supper. My lad has always been well fed.
Had the experiment past 11 plus.
You watch with that ink, Alfie. I'm ironing. Come in, the door's open.
Hello, hello, Mrs. Padgett.
Yes?
I'm your neighbour from next door. I thought I'd welcome you in. The name's Ramsbottom with a TH, not a double T.
How nice, Mr. Ramsbottom. This is my husband, Albert.
Oh, how do? Well, we'll have to get together and show the women a thing or two, eh? If you want any help with the gardening, Ramsbottom's your man, especially roses.
Oh, sorry, Mrs. Padgett. I didn't realise you had company.
Oh, come in, Mr. Hopkins. Mr. Ramsbottom, this is our lodger, Mr. Hopkins. He's training to be an insanitary inspector.
No, Mrs. P, sanitary inspector.
Oh, have you changed your job, then?
I'll do. Roses is my line. I'm very good with roses. I was just saying.
Is that so? Mrs. Padgett, I wonder if Mr. Padgett could help me with moving my furniture.
He's not moving anything till he's had his supper.
Anyone know the square root of 15? Uncle?
I don't know what he wants, Ma. I've asked him once. You mind with that ink, Alfie?
It'll only take a minute.
Give him an egg. He was always fond of an egg.
I found a new way of doing them.
What, roses?
No, eggs.
Will you have an egg, Albert, or something else?
A boiled egg, please, my love. A boiled egg, please,
will you have an egg, Albert? Or something else?
Egg, please, my
love. Going for a walk, Albert?
Yes, going for a walk.
Poached egg on toast?
A boiled egg, please, my love.
Have a biscuit.
A boiled egg, please, my love.
And see the roses.
Albert?
A boiled egg, please, my love.
What about an egg, Albert?
Yes.
Oh, no, a good recipe for eggs.
Give me an olive.
I work with roses, my love.
Very good with butter. I'm
not expecting
to do anything. What about an egg, Albert?
Roses is good.
What do you think you're doing? Leslie will be furious.
You must be raving mad. We're on the air. Look, what's the idea? Come back here. We've bought an egg.
Swim. I'd sink like a stone.
Half-hour television show. Half an hour to put the world right.
What can you do in half an hour? I need at least 40 minutes. And I can do without that lot back there as well. How would you like your egg done, dear? The golden years of British entertainment. So much for Shakespeare and Sophocles. I prithee, husband, I will not trouble thee, my love, beyond thine intelligence, to what degree of hardness thou requirest in thine egg. Act 4, Scene 2, Omelette the Prince. How would you like your egg done, dear? And that neighbour. People just don't have neighbours like that. They're the sort of people you see walking past here. They're all potential neighbours. Take him, for instance. He could be my neighbour. That's a good idea. Add a touch of class to the buildings. You ought to be able to pick your neighbour anyway. I mean, you have to live next door to them all the time. Good morning. I'm thinking of moving into the Penge area. Can you show me a selection of your latest neighbours? No. I don't think any of them are really me. Do you know what I mean? Oh. No, I wouldn't mind having her as a neighbour. Sorry to trouble you, miss, while your husband's away, but I wonder if you could lend me a cup of sugar. No. Don't bother to get out of the bath. I'll find it. I wonder what they'd think if they knew what I was thinking about. I suppose everyone's got to think about something.
If only I'd had my teeth in at the time, things would have been much easier all round, because, oh, well, it's no good thinking about it.
Now, if I show her those photographs I've got, perhaps she would be a little more inclined to...
Honestly, I really don't know what the judge means by evidence. I have the blunt instrument and everything. What else does he want?
You can't tell what they're thinking, really, not by looking at them. Ah, the captain, someone's on the gun. I'm going to make up a new language. Just words that express how I feel right now. Right. Foremansville. That sounds very good. It's a very fair word. Kaplotchk. Splelge. Spoogelcrane. Spumatz. Spinglehalt. It's a very good word, that. Spugelholt. I think I'll try that out. Flangewick.
Klitterweiss.
Hendelcraw.
Mandelsow.
Pendelween.
Patty Marr.
Patty Marr. That's very good.
Thank you.
Not at all. It's very good.
I rather like Flangewick.
Flange. Well, thank you very much. You see, language is no barrier. How'd you do? Working?
No, just been down to Crufts for a job. Nothing doing.
No. You watch the television match?
All the time.
Who's your favourite?
Lassie, of course. I reckon her show's smashing. I like the way she gives her tail a flick when she sings, I make him whoopee.
Lassie singing? I've never heard Lassie sing.
You're not a dog, are you?
That's true. What do you think about Rin Tin Tin?
Do me a favour, Rin Tin Tin. Enough to give you a pain in the paws. It's all too exaggerated.
How do you mean, exaggerated?
Look at last week when he went chasing those Indians through the wood. No dog could pass all those trees without stopping once.
Not true to life?
No. Well, can't stay here talking to you all day. What would the other dogs say if they found me talking to a man? They put me away.
Yes, I suppose they would.
See you.
See you. Mr. Khrushchev warned the Hungarian delegation that they would have to... A 21-year-old girl was found not guilty of... The Republican Party announced in Chicago that they wouldn't... A 21-year-old girl was found not guilty of thumbing lifts in long-distance lorries. City notes. Sensation in stock exchange. Big takeover bid to rescue British imports. The stock exchange and the whole of the city literally wait until 2 o'clock this afternoon to learn the fate of £1 million commercial empire representing over 25% of our national economy. Its fate lies in the hands of Sir Geoffrey Jerome, quiet, home-loving multimillionaire who must make a bid by 2 p.m. to save a takeover bid by an American syndicate. That's a sign of the times, that is, when you can be nabbed for thumbing lifts in long-distance lorries. How can you be found not guilty of thumbing lifts in long-distance lorries? I mean, it's not the sort of thing there can be any mistake about. Do you swear to tell the whole truth and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Will you tell the court in your own words, did you or did you not thumb a lift on a long-distance lorry?
No, sir.
My lord, I think this proves pretty conclusively that the defendant did not thumb a lift on a long-distance lorry.
Oi! Do you do that in your own home?
I beg your pardon?
The paper.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Fell out of my trousers.
The 21-year-old girl was found not guilty. Sir Geoffrey Jerome, quiet, home-loving multimillionaire, will take over bid. Oh, we've heard all this before.
Don't you think he'll pull it off, sir?
Very likely, but this bit about the girl is rubbish, absolute rubbish. I ought to know.
Yes, I suppose you did. Well, see you.
See you. Oh, do you mind closing the lid properly, old man?
Oh, sorry. Funny man. I much prefer to travel in a car like this. You meet a better class of people altogether. Look at the character in that millionaire face. Sir Geoffrey, how's your father? The takeover big geezer. I better not get in his way, he's got enough on his mind. I wouldn't be in his shoes for 10 million quid. His head must be going mad with figures.
2430? Or was it 2340? I must find that girl's number.
The financial structure of the country rests on his puny shoulders. I'm seeing history in the making here. Britain will be proud of you, sir.
2034? No, no. That was the number of the little fair-headed thing. Now, she had a nice shape. Not as full as Veronica's.
How can he carry all those figures in his head like that? He must be a genius. He is a genius.
4320. That's it. I'll write it down while I remember. I've got a shocking head for figures.
I thought so. There you are. He does it by code. That's the secret. 4320. The future of the country depends on that bare figure. What a mind.
She looked beautiful in those velvet jodhpurs.
I hope you pull it off, sir. The country is by your side, waiting and watching.
This is it, John.
This is it, eh? To take over or not to take over, that is the question.
don't want to hurry you, sir, but it's nearly 2 o'clock and the whole country's waiting in the balance.
Don't stand about, darling.
Sir, you've only got 2.5 minutes, sir. Sir? Sir, just a minute.
Two o'clock. Oh, well, bang goes the financial security of the country. Still, there must be more important things in life than money. Of course there are. There are lots of things more important than money. Trouble is, not everyone can afford them. There's that darling again. She's more important than money. Hey, she's looking at me. Look at her eyes. They're following me all the time. I think she fancies me. She's even looking at me upside down.
thank you. We already have one.
Excuse me, sir. Is that your vehicle?
Yes, as a matter of fact, it is.
Can't you see the notice? No parking, 6 AM, 6 PM, month set.
Yeah, I know, but I'm doing a bit of business here. I'm selling this.
I don't see anyone buying it.
Well, actually, I was gonna sell it in here. Sell it.
Come in. There's a very interesting program on. There's a chap trying to get rid of a vacuum cleaner. Come and see.
I am a walking television show. I can't get away from them. Big Brother's watching me, and Big Dad, and Big Mum. The whole family's watching me. I'm like a goldfish in a bowl. I'm a poor squirming squingle under a microscope. Leave me alone. Leave me alone, will you? I've got a right to me privacy. I just walked out of all this. I don't want to know. Now leave me alone. Switch me off. I've got a right to me own privacy. I'm going to live me own life. Switch off. But will you stop it and leave me alone? Go back. Don't follow me. Will you? There ought to be a law. This is a free country and I shouldn't have to have this problem. Now leave me alone. I warn you.